Hey YouTube, what's up? This is Tony. I was wanting to make a unboxing video, but I've already unboxed stuff, so excuse me, I've got a little excited about this when this come in the mail. Let me explain what this video is. As a lot of you know, I am an average watcher of Super Geeked Up here on YouTube. Created by Jeff Burns, the creator of Super Knocked Up. If you get a chance, go and watch it every week and participate in the fun at SKU Web Series here on YouTube. So, anyway, about 2 weeks ago, SGU crew, a Super Geeked Up crew, they had this really neat guy that I've gotten to know a little bit on Facebook and got to know him through Super Geeked Up, and hopefully I'll get to know him through ham radio too, because I know he's a ham radio operator like I am. But his name is Emmett Plant. Let me check, see if that's Emmett Plant. Plant like a tree or something like that. So, anyway, Emmett is a really cool guy. The reason that Super Geeked Up had him on is because of the fact that he produces a lot of Star Trek stuff, particularly Star Trek audiobooks. And so the hangout that night, which they had some technical difficulties at night. The hangout got abruptly terminated in the middle of the hangout, so it become a two-part series. But anyway, they were having a contest on that night, saying, "What's your favorite Klingon word?" And well, they had some other stuff too, and some other people from Super Geeked Up won pretty much the same kind of box that I did. Maybe they got different stuff, but I don't know. But the question that I ended up answering was, "What's your favorite Klingon word?" Well, pretty much the only Klingon word that I know is the word for a Klingon delicacy. That is pretty much bloodworms, a soup, and it's called gah, gah. It's spelled GAGH. I'm pretty sure because I'm a Trekkie and yeah, I know these things. Random things that I really, really just. They're important to me to know, okay? Just important. So anyway, I tweeted, "Hey, that's my favorite word, gah." And so I might be putting the right inflections or tones in that because I can't make phlegm whatsoever. So anyway, I won. I won pretty much because I was the first tweeter. Yay! I was the first tweeter of that question, and so I won essentially Emmett's book, How to Speak, How to Talk Klingon, and he said later in the hangout that if those who win will also be getting other Star Trek stuff, because of his love of Star Trek and also because of a website that he runs. Before I show you the stuff in the box, let me explain what Emmett's website is. Emmett's website is called Trek Fan. Now, Trek Fan is a kind of like a bulletin board. You can go on there and talk about Star Trek related stuff and read up on Star Trek related news and things. I'll put a link somewhere up here, 'cause I'm gonna try this cards thing that YouTube has got, and so hopefully it will work. I'll also put links to the Hangout, both parts, in this video also. But the website Trek Fan is pretty much just a bulletin board kind of thing. You can go on there and get news, Star Trek related news. You can leave messages to other fans and just kind of communicate back and forth. I know Star Trek fan, Trek fan, excuse me. Emmett has a node set up on Echolink. If you don't know what Echolink is, you probably don't know if you're not a ham radio operator, but it's a way for ham radio operators to talk to each other back and forth through the internet, through repeaters. So, I've been an active user of Echolink for quite a while. Emmett told me the other day that they do have a node set up for Trek Fan for fellow Star Trek enthusiasts who are ham radio operators. And one good thing I know about Emmett and Trek Fan is that his group, Trek Fan, helps people interested in ham radio get their first ham radio license, which I think that's great and wonderful from what I've heard. So, go check out Emmett on Facebook. Tell him that I said hi, and don't know if he's got a like page. I don't believe he does because I've tried to look for it and never did pop up. But anyway, this is pretty much just an unboxing video of the stuff that I won. That was from Trek Fan. And look, first off, let me show you the box here. This is the box, and then there's the symbol right there for the Federation, the Starfleet Academy right there, which is really cool. In Star Trek, San Francisco, X Astris Center Centia. Centrica. Yeah, I'm not good speaking Latin or that would be, I believe that's Latin right there. I'm not sure. You know, I should know that because of being a Trekkie fan. But yeah, that's the one of the symbols for Starfleet Academy. He's got some other cool stuff on this box here. I don't know if you can see it. Well, it's upside down, but you can see it. There's the great Leonard Nimoy as Spock, and then no, you did not see that part, even though it was upside down. But you know, I don't care. I don't care. It's on there. You know, there's probably other ways you can get my address anyway. But I don't care. So anyway, on with the unboxing of the Star Trek stuff, mostly books and stuff. First book I got was pretty an old book. Matter of fact, I have this book in my collection, but you know me, it's Star Trek stuff, so I'll add it to my collection. It's a Star Trek novel. Web of the Romulans by M.S. Murdoch. Even though I have this book in my collection, I bought it at a second. Oh, cool. Well, here's something I didn't see when I first opened it up. This it's got a little sticker on here that says Trek Fan. It's got the address for Trek Fan. Trekfan.org. It says, "This book is yours for free. When you're finished, please pass it on to the next Trek fan you know." So more than likely, I will be sending this to somebody else Not sure who yet, but I probably will be. Jeff, do you want this book? Jeff Burns, do you want this book right here? Matter of fact, here's another book that I already have. Matter of fact, I've never read this book, but I have this book, and part of the reason I haven't read this book is because it's called The Genesis Wave, Book 3. Now, I never did get Book 1 or Book 2, so I'm the type of person, I'm not going to read a book unless I have the other parts. So, if you're a Star Trek fan and you're watching this, and you want these two books, please let me know. I'll try to get them to you as best as I can. So, anyway, what else we got in here? Now, this book I don't have, and I probably will read it. Star Trek Next Generation: Battle of the Beta Zed by Charlotte Douglas and Susan Kearney. Don't have this book, so I'm glad I've got this book. Of course, it's got a pretty picture of Deanna Troi right on the cover, and holding a massive Starfleet issued rifle gun right there. That's so wonderful. So yeah, I will be reading this book over the next few weeks, mainly because I don't have it and I appreciate getting it. So, what else we got? Oh, comic books. You know, I love comic books. And these are two comic books I don't have, mainly because of the fact that when I collected comic books big and heavy, my comic shop just really was a small comic shop, and they didn't want to order stuff that not a lot of people asked for. And so, for some reason, way back in the mid-90s, when I was asking for this stuff, they said, no, not a lot of people's asking for that, so, you know, we're not going to order it. But, yeah, two Star Trek comics. I probably won't open these up because of the fact that they're sealed in the Mylar packaging, and I oils on the fingers and pages and oil transfers and starts deteriorating the pages, and I'm like, no. Hopefully this thing is in near mint condition. Mint condition. Hopefully Emmett can tell me if this is in mint condition, near mint condition, what kind of condition these are in. But yeah, I will be adding these to my comic book collection. Matter of fact, in the next few weeks, don't know when exactly, but look for it in the next few months. I will be showing off some of my comic book collection. Kind of going through some of my personal stuff, and just now getting around to going through a lot of my stuff. So I'll be going through my comic book collection and reliving a lot of memories. So yeah, this will be added to my comic book collection right here. Then what do we got? Looks like a bunch of stuff here. More stuff I probably won't open, because I realize that if I open it up, then I will take the value off of the stuff, and it's really bad that I'm not going to be able to see what these are, because of the fact I'm not going to be opening them up. But I really just want to keep these in near mint condition as I can. Here's some Star Trek Skybox Master Series Star Trek Edition. This is part of a card game. Again, I won't be opening these up because it'll take the value off of them. Here's the Star Trek Next Generation, the inaugural edition. Here's 12 full color trading cards of Star Trek the original series, which I probably I wish I could open these up, but I don't want to take the value off of them, so I'm not. Again, here's more the episode collection, season 5, 91 to 92. There's some cards in here that show pictures of season 5. Here's some that are from Star Trek Voyager right here. More of that. We'll see that. And some more of this. And yeah, I mean, I appreciate getting these. I loved trading cards when I was a kid, but you know, this is Star Trek related stuff. If I open it up, I'll take the depreciation off of it. And so I just would rather not. You know, I've got a deck of playing cards that are Star Trek related playing cards that somebody gave me for my birthday a few years ago. I still haven't opened them up because I'm like, nope, not opening them up. It will take the value off of the collectible if I open them up. And I said the only way that I would open them up is if I were at a Comic Con or a Star Trek convention, and some of the actors were there and were there to sign some of my cards, which is getting kind of hard because they're starting to excuse me. That is not nice. They're starting to all die off, which is life. So, yeah. Anyway, the last thing that's in the list here, the book of the books, is the book I won originally. Star Trek: How to Speak Klingon, which is really cool. I have this book, and it's audio tape, the audio tape book, and so. Of course, right here, first page, it shows how to speak the pronunciation. The thing about this book here is it's a talking book. So I took the tab off. Let's see if it works. Which I don't believe it's going to work. I believe the batteries have expired a long time ago. Who knows how long the batteries have expired. So, oh, that's kind of a pity that it didn't work, because it oh, look here, look, how to speak Klingon at a restaurant. And of course, there's some of the lovely there's a Klingon right there, and then right there's some lovely gaw, and this Romulan kind of guy. Or normal looking kind of guy. He's like, and so let's see if it tells here how to say, oh, okay, how to say, no thanks, I'm allergic to gaw. So yeah, and I was right. The right pronunciation of gaw is GAGH. So, yay, Star Trek knowledge. Yay, I know it. It says I'm not even gonna try it right now because I need to look at some of the pronunciations of the letters and the vowels if they even have some of this stuff. But anyway, this video has gone on for 19 minutes and 30 seconds now. So yeah, wow, this is a pretty long video. Sorry that I sneezed in the middle of it, but you know, life happens, and that's life. So anyway, Emmett Plant, thank you so much for the Star Trek stuff. I really do appreciate it. If you get a chance, go and go to Trek Fan, which is trekfan.org. It's also on the web, a longer title, but I'm not going to say it because I don't know it right offhand. But I will be putting a link somewhere. Hopefully, the cards thing will work. If not, I'll be putting a link down in the description bar to Trek Fan so you can join up. Again, my name is Tony, and thank you for watching, and I'll see you one later. Bye.